Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent.
Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopard Basketball is brought to you by Waldman Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Waldman Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley. Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof. Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside. Major's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin, a beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopard Basketball is brought to you by Waldman Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Waldman Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley. Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof. Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside.
Major's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin, a beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopards basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley.
Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof. Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside. Major's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin, a beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Leopards basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley. Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber and Topping, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof. Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside. Nature's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin. A beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima, or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Leopards basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley. Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber and Topping, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof. Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside. Major's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin. A beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community.
open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima, or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Leopard basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Zilla Alumni Gymnasium as we get ready to start this SCAC contest between the Leopards and the Wahluke Warriors. And this one is to go to the district championship, which will be played in Wahluke. I'm sure Wahluke would like to play in a district championship game in their own gym. Probably something that they would definitely prefer to do rather than make a trip all the way to Toppenish to play the winner of the Natchez Connell game, and that's going to be played this evening. So I might have time to get down there to Connell to watch that one. Definitely got time to get up to Royal to watch the Royal Toppenish game at 7:30, and the Wapato Kaibibi game is being played simultaneous with this one. So those, that is your slate today. So we'll be a little late updating as far as who plays who in the next round, but we'll definitely get you updated sometime this evening before the night is through. Starters for tonight's ball game look like this for the Warriors. They are coached by Clayton Buck. Arnaldo Ramos is a senior at 5'6". He is number two. Number 11 is Maximiliano, and we're going to take our pin and mark out the end of that name right there. He's Max tonight, and it is I have a phonetic spelling for this last name, and I hope I don't dog it too much. Urushia, I believe is how you say it, and I'm going to check it again first break. Orlando Nunez is a junior at 5'11", number 23. Number 32 is Andrew Jorgensen. He's a 6'1 sophomore, and Carlos Lugo is a senior at 5'11". He wears number 40. Zilla starters look like they have the last few games. Clay Delp, a 6'1 senior, wears number 0. Carlos Perez is a 6'2 senior. He wears number 2. Ashton Waldman, another senior in the starting lineup. He is a 6'2 guard, and he wears number 21. Nakia John, a sophomore at 6'3, wears number 24. Rounding out the starting five, Luke Navarre, a 6'4 junior. And those are your starters for the Leopards tonight. And let me quickly take a look and see how bad I dog that. I've got a phonetic spelling, thanks to Louise. And Urutia. And I hope I am able to say it correctly tonight. We'll see how it goes. And Urutia. So Max Urutia, he is a 6 foot senior. I don't know that I got to that part, but those are your starters for today's ball game. District semifinal. The winner will play the winner of the other semifinal, Toppenish and Royal, on Saturday night at Wahluke. Loser's going to have to fight their way out of the loser's bracket in Toppenish on Thursday. Opening tip controlled by Delp. And Delp now goes down on the baseline for Waldman. Waldman comes around up top.
Gets it back to Delp in the corner. 2-3 zone being employed, and Navarre is going to try a three ball. It just rattles out, and a loose ball on the baseline knocked out of bounds, and they award it to Wahluke. 7:44 to play here, opening period. Zilla will come out and pressure as they're able to break pressure, but the ball knocked away, controlled by Delp. Long pass up the floor to Waldman. Waldman, a little crossover move, missed the shot. And a loose ball going to be grabbed by John. And what do they got? We got a foul call? So Nakia is going to be tagged with a foul here early. So number one on him. Not quite 30 seconds in, as they'll get the ball in for Ramos. He'll go back over on the right side, and now the ball knocked away. Perez will have it, gives it up to Navarre. Now to Clay, right side. Delp traveled with it, so another turnover on the Leopards. As they get the ball in and go over on the right side, and they're able to break pressure here as Nunez gets it down low. Now up top. Three ball on the way, and that's good for Ramos. So now we've got a timeout, an official's timeout. Not too sure why. Maybe something on the floor already? As the official calls a timeout. And so a stoppage in play here. And now they're going to have to talk things over with the officials. And officials having a little conference at midcourt. Not too sure what the discussion is about. Thought maybe it was just the floor was, you know, had some kind of moisture on it. No call. Just a conference with the officials. All right. So... not too sure what the conversation was about, as Delp now will bring it up into front court. I don't think Chauncey did either, as they'll get it over on the right side to Sandoval. Now Navarre, right side, got it, as Sandoval in early for Waldman here. As they'll get the ball in the middle of the floor, and now get it over on the left side for Arushia. And now a shot put up, missed. Rebound Sandoval. Izzy will push it up the floor. Gets it to Perez. Perez straight to the glass with the left hand. He's fouled. And are they going to say that was on the floor? He pointed towards the baseline. Like it's going to be a base. And no, they're going to give him two shots here. So Perez will be at the free throw line to shoot two. Foul is charged to Ramos. His first. First one missed. Carlos will get a second. And he hit the free throw. I think we would have had a lane violation if he hadn't. As this one comes in for Nunez. Nunez goes over on the right side. And now across the timeline, they'll bring it down the right side to Ruscia. And then that's going out of bounds. Awarded back to Zilla. As he tried to get it down in the corner into the hands of Lugo, and it goes out of bounds. 3-3 is our score as Delp brings it up the floor here, mishandles a little, gets the dribble back. Delp now into the right wing, go up top, and now Sandoval loses it, turned over, and it'll be brought up the floor here by Wahluke, and a shot opportunity, and a foul is called here on Navarre, as Arushia got it down there deep and just about worked himself into a three-point play. 6:04 to play opening period. And Arushia missed the first. And it might be Arutia. Arutia. Rutia gets the second, and it is a 4-3 ball game as they get it up the floor. Now up top with it is Delp. Delp put it in motion now. Gets down into the corner. We'll go out for Sandoval. Now Navarre right side. Pump fake. Now we'll dribble into traffic. They swing it around. Here's Nakia from the left corner. That's off the iron. Going to be rebounded in there by Ramos. And Ramos will bring it up the floor. Ramos all the way down and the right block, puts one off the glass and through. It is 6-3 Wahluke. So here comes Delp. Delp comes down, tried to throw a pass. That's going to be another turnover as he tried to get it down into the corner and Izzy had vacated that spot. So 6-3. And Wahluke will inbound. Now a one-handed pass down the floor over on the left-hand side into the hands of Jorgensen. As they'll get it down and a little up and under move, no good. Going to be rebounded, however, and kicked out. And now back to Jorgensen on the right block. A little turnaround in the lane. Got it. 8-3 as Delp will bring it up the floor. Delp now comes down, and they're going to call a foul on the floor. No shot attempt as it went through. And they're going to call Lugo with the foul. It'll be his first. So Delp to inbound, gets it in to Perez. Perez kicks out, and here comes Sandoval. His shot blocked out of bounds. As Ramos was there to check the shot. 4:56 to play here, first period. As they get it in. And now swing it around to Perez, down to Delp in the corner. Three ball on the way is off the iron. It's going to be rebounded by Nunez. And now up the floor, Urrutia will get it into the lane. Almost lost it. Now loose ball out of bounds. Going to be awarded back to Wahluke as Navarre was down there and got a hand on it. So they get the ball in, down in the corner, and Ramos puts it up. I think Perez might have got a piece of that as Perez at midcourt, and now the ball in backcourt, and they'll give it up. Clay will bring it up. Gets it over on the left side. Down in the corner here is Navarre off the iron. Long rebound grabbed by Delp. Delp kicks out Sandoval. Right back to Delp. Delp will drive baseline. Comes all the way down to the glass and puts it in. 8-5, 4:05 to play here, first period. As they'll get it up the floor on the right side. And an underhanded pass over on the left side. Shot put up and hit by Nunez. 10-5. So here comes Delp. Delp will bring it down the floor. Runner in the lane, no good. And probably looking for a whistle there. As they'll get it up the floor now for Nunez. Nunez comes down into the paint, loses the basketball. Gets it back, is able to kick it out for Ramos, who puts it in. 12-5, Wahluke. As Delp gets it into front court, goes over to Sandoval, now up top. And Luke goes into traffic, no call. Ball batted around, Navarre has it, put back short, rebounded by Jorgensen. So Jorgensen, a couple of dribbles in backcourt, and he gives it up. It is Urrutia who brings it up, and now Ramos may have walked there. Ramos top of the key gives off for Lugo. Lugo bounce pass in. Urrutia from the free throw line missed it, and the ball will be saved, but into the hands of Nakia. He'll get it over on the right side to Clay. Now kicked out for Perez. They'll swing it around to Sandoval. Down to Luke in the corner. Navarre is going to drive baseline, gets to the glass and puts it in. 12-7, 2:45 to play first period. As they get it up the floor here and now kick it out up top to Ramos. Ramos top of the key, pump fake. Got Nakia in the air. They got it back to Ramos, but it was knocked out of bounds and they award it to Zilla. Substitutions for the Leopards as Nick Navarre in, Ashton Waldman returns, Carson Favilla in, and also Yvonne Torres into the ballgame. So long pass to Favilla. He'll get it right back to Delp. Now up top to Navarre. Swing it around to Waldman. He'll try a three ball. That's off the iron. Navarre, boy, over the back. And that's going to go out of bounds as Nick was all over. And substitution for Wahluke as River Buck, freshman, into the ballgame. So they get it in, and it'll be brought up by Ramos. Ramos into front court, comes down to the free throw line, kicks out, and it's going to be chased down out there by Buck. And he'll give it up, swinging around to Jorgensen. Jorgensen hands off. Here's a three ball on the way. That's no good, and it'll go out of bounds and be awarded to Zilla as Ramos misses from the right wing. 12-7 Wahluke, just under 2 minutes to play here in the first. As Delp will bring it up the floor. Delp comes off a pick just beyond the free throw line, misses, and that's going to be batted, saved, and out of bounds. It'll be awarded back to Zilla. A minute 43 to play. As Torres will inbound, gets it into Delp. Clay, top of the key, comes off a pick and kicks out for Waldman. Three ball right wing, got it. 12-10, a minute and a half to play here in the first. So bring it up the left side with Nunez, and now swing it around to Jorgensen. Jorgensen now will come down the right side, gets down to the right block, hands off. Down in the corner, Urrutia misses, and a rebound grab by Waldman. So here comes Ashton with a basketball. Ashton kicks out, and oh, just as Favela went to vacate, Ashton threw it right where Carson had been standing. And a turnover as Oscar Perez checks in for Wahluke. Checking in for Zilla is Izzy Sandoval. Clay Delp will have a seat. As they get the ball in, it'll be brought up by Jorgensen. Jorgensen comes all the way down to the left elbow, kicks out up top to Buck. Buck swings it around to Jorgensen, left side. Jorgensen now, free throw line. And coming down the left side of the lane, we're going to get a whistle and a blocking call. That's going to go against Torres. It'll be number one on Yvonne. And they're going to send Urrutia to the free throw line. Inside the final minute here in the first period. First free throw off the heel. Urrutia will get one more. Got the second one. And it is 13-10. So pressure here from Wahluke. And Waldman says, hey, everybody just go down. It's man press. I'll take it up. And Waldman's just going to go the length of the floor. Went up, had it kind of altered, and came up short. And now up top, they'll swing it around. Here's Jorgensen for a three. That's off the iron. Batted, going to be grabbed out there by Urrutia. And now coming down, falling down with a basketball picked up by Izzy. Izzy will push it the other way. Izzy all the way to the glass. Boy, they're going to give it back to Zilla, and it was Izzy who touched it last. But, oh, no, they're going to call a foul here. So Urrutia is going to pick up the foul. Or actually, they indicate Oscar Perez for the foul. So it'll be number one on him. Sandoval to inbound. Gets it in to Navarre. Nick up and under move. Won't go. Izzy ends up with a loose ball. Put it up short. Now batted. Favela will have it. Gets it to Waldman. Ashton up top. 12 seconds to play. Zilla can run out the clock as they get it to Sandoval. Sandoval in the lane. Put it up short. A lot of contact. And now we're going to get a jump ball. An alternating possession belongs to Wahluke with 4.5 seconds to play. As they get this one in, and now They'll quickly get it up the floor, kick it out to Jorgensen. Did he get it off in time? It doesn't matter. It didn't go. At the end of one, Wahluke 13, Zilla 10. We'll take a break. Come back for the second period after this timeout.
Our local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopards basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley.
Play with a little jumper off the right side makes this a one-point ball game, 13-12. As Arutia will have it, he'll bring it down the right side. Kicks out, three ball on the way, and that's good. That is River Buck, the freshman, with the three. It's 16-12. And now loose ball as John just kind of threw it to nobody. Here's Buck again, and that's no good. And Luke goes up and gets a rebound. So here comes Luke at the other end, and he's going to pick it out. And now turnover, and what have we got? Traveling is called, as on the floor with the basketball was Arutia. So it'll be Zilla ball on their own baseline. So Delp to inbound. Up top for Avila. Back over on the right side to Delp. Down in the corner to Perez. Inside to Navarre. Navarre kicks out to Delp. Kind of high. Delp will take the 23-footer. It's off the back iron. And that's going to be rebounded by Jorgensen. So Wahluke will have it. They lead by four, 16-12, as Arutia will bring it into front court. Arutia down into the lane, and a little scoop shot won't go. Navarre grabs the rebound, gets it up to Clay. Clay now makes a move into the paint. A lot of contact, no call, and a rebound grab by Arutia. So now a long pass up the floor. Left side shot put up and hit by Perez, and it's they call it a three ball, 19-12, as Luke or as Delp tried to drive the lane, drew the foul, and that is going to be on Perez, his second. So Clay Delp at the free throw line. First one is good. Delp hits both, makes this a five-point game, 19-14, and now a steal in backcourt by Avila. Avila kicks it out to Delp. Delp way out high on the left side, gets it down to John, kicked out now to Perez. Perez up top, gives it off to Navarre. Delp on a cut, gets into a triple team, and is still able to score it off the window, 19-16. As a cross-court pass, and now we're going to get a timeout taken by Wahluke. We'll take a break and be back after this timeout.
Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof.
Nature's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
Welcome back here. Three-point ball game, 19-16. 6:01 to play here in the first half. It will be Wahluke basketball after the timeout. Zilla is going to change things up here. They're going to go to man pressure. And now they'll get it in backcourt, and bring it across with Nunez. And now a steal by Luke. Navarre takes it in for the two-handed jam. And it's a one-point ball game, 19-18, 5:45 to play. As Urrutia will have it up top. Gets it over on the left side now to Nunez. Nunez will pick up the dribble and gives off to Buck. And now Urrutia over to Jorgensen. Jorgensen in the paint. This one is high off the rim. No good. Rebounded by Navarre and given to Delp. Inside for John. He has stripped of the basketball. They're going to give it back to Wahluke. Probably a pretty good call if he didn't get fouled, as Arnaldo Ramos returns for the Warriors. 5:16 to play. One-point ball game. They'll get it in for Buck. Buck in backcourt will go over to Urrutia. He'll bring it across the timeline. Urrutia left side now up top for Ramos. Ramos looks at the three. Now we'll take the three, and it's an air ball grabbed in there by Perez. He'll get it up the floor. Here's Owen with the basketball. He'll give it off to Perez. Now over on the right side, Luke, wide open three ball. That's off the iron, rebounded by Delp. Clay goes right back up, draws a foul, and will go to the line. First one is good. Waldman returns. Sandoval returns. As Avila and John sit down. Clay ties the game with the first free throw. Zilla has their first lead here with 4:46 to play in the first half. 20-19. As Buck will have the basketball, gives off to Ramos. Ramos now top of the key, comes over to the right elbow, puts up a shot from there. It's short, going to be rebounded by Navarre, and now a long pass for Ramos, or for Perez, kicked out, and now over to Waldman in the corner, fakes a pass, puts it on the floor, goes up top to Sandoval. Izzy looked at the shot, gave it up to Perez. Now Delp will have it. Delp left side, bounce pass into Luke. Luke under the glass, couldn't quite get there to get to the front of the glass. And it's 20-19. Urrutia goes over into the corner. Here's Nunez for a three. That's going to be rebounded by Waldman. And here comes Delp. Delp now makes a spin move into the lane, high off the window, no good. Going to be rebounded down there by Buck. And now over on the right side with the basketball is Urrutia. Now Ramos. Swing it around down into the corner. As that ball's batted and will go out of bounds, awarded back to Wahluke. As they get it in for Ramos. Ramos gets it in over on the left side to Buck. Buck now up top to Urrutia. Urrutia back over to Ramos. Now back down into the corner. It's Buck. As an entry pass batted away, going to be picked up as the shot clock expires and it doesn't hit anything, and it'll go out of bounds and it'll be Zilla ball. So Clayton Buck will make a move here as he'll put Oscar Perez back into the ball game to replace Urrutia. 3:21 to play first half, 20-19. As Delp runs into some trouble at midcourt and now goes over to Sandoval. Swing it around to Waldman. Three ball on the way. Good. 23-19. 3:07 to play as they quickly get the ball up the floor. Here's a runner, and that's good from Nunez, I believe. It might have been Buck. It's hard to tell the difference between 22 and 23 with these uniforms. As they get it in for Navarre, Luke puts one no good. Got his own rebound and put it back. 25-21, as it will be Perez with the basketball. Perez on the left side. Perez hands off, and Ramos will have it. And now flips it out. Waldman there to get it. Here comes Ashton all the way to the glass. Missed it with the left hand. And Ramos is there for the rebound. So they'll bring it the other way. Back up top to Ramos. Now on the left side, Perez. Down into the corner for Lugo. Back to Ramos as in the rotation, and a block shot from Waldman as that was going to coming up from Nunez. Jorgensen back into the ball game. He'll replace Buck. 2:13 to play first half. Zilla up by four, 25-21. Both teams a little cold shooting as they bring it out. And now swing it around down into the corner for Nunez. Nunez makes a move down the right side. Had it stripped. It'll go out of bounds, be awarded back to Wahluke with two on the shot clock. So they'll have to get a shot up quickly here. And they do, and it's no good. Rebounded by Perez. And now Sandoval will have it. Gets it over to Perez. Perez spots up. That's going to be offline. Rebounded by Delp. Kicked out up top. Here's Navarre from the top of the key. Three ball. Good. 28-21. A minute 45 to play here in the first half. As they'll bring it up on the right side. And Perez stole it. Got it to Delp. Delp down the middle of the floor. Gives it off to Navarre. Lay in. Good. 30-21. And a timeout taken by Zilla. We'll take a break and be back after this timeout.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin. A beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Welcome back here. A minute 31 to play. And Zilla up by 9:30-21. And a long discussion during that timeout by Clayton Buck with his Warriors. As he'll get the ball into Ramos, and now right back, Urrutia back into the ball game. Urrutia will come down right side, and they got an offensive foul as Delp had great position all the way down the floor, and Urrutia used the off arm to push him. So, number one on Urrutia. So here's Delp with the basketball. He'll work it up against Lugo. Now it goes over to Sandoval, right side. Sandoval up top. He'll try the three ball. That's off the front. Going to be rebounded by Jorgensen. Jorgensen now will put it on the floor, and he'll bring it up. Jorgensen hands off to Ramos. Oh, Navarre just about came away with one. As Jorgensen gets down into the paint and scores it, it is 30-23. Here comes Sandoval. Izzy now up top for Perez. Now back to Sandoval. Sandoval gives it off to Navarre. And he tried to go down the back. And luckily it was touched by a Warrior as it went out of bounds. So Zilla will have possession on the baseline. 14 on the shot clock. Delp to inbound. Gets it in up top for Sandoval. Now over to Luke. Navarre kicks out for Waldman. Waldman will take the shot from there. That's going to rattle out. And a rebound grabbed, and they'll push it up the floor here as Nunez fights his way to the glass and scores it. So 30-25 as Delp will have it right side. Shot clock off. Delp gets down on the baseline. Up top for Navarre. Luke comes all the way down into the, well, had a lot of contact. Luke just fights his way back up and used a little contact of his own to score at 32-27. Arutia from midcourt, and that gets nowhere. So at the end of the first half, it is Zilla 32, Wahluke 25. We'll take a break. We'll come back with the second half after this timeout.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent.
Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopard basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley.
Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof. Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside.
Nature's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
Smudgebot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin, a beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudgebot Clothing Company at smudgebot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent.
Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopard basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley.
Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof.
Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside.
Nature's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin. A beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent.
Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-through for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopards basketball is brought to you by Walden Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Walden Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley.
Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof.
Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside.
Nature's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin. A beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn. Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent.
Welcome back here as we get ready for the second half. Leopards lead 32-25 after one half of play. And it will be Wahluke basketball to start the second half. They will get it in to Ramos, and now up top, Jorgensen. Jorgensen gives it off, and driving down a little runner, it comes up short, loose ball picked up by Nakia, and now Clay will have it. He'll give it off for Navarre, and a reverse lay-in is good for Luke, 34-25. So get it to Urrutia, and Urrutia inside, and that ball's batted, going to be grabbed by Luke. Luke one-on-one with Jorgensen, comes under the glass, rifles it into Nakia. He draws the foul and gets the bucket to go. So Nakia will be at the free throw line to shoot one. The foul is on Lugo, his second. And so John hits the free throw, and it is 37-25, Zilla, as Ramos will have it up top. Ramos comes onto the right block, puts up a shot, and that's good from the right elbow. And a long pass up the floor for Nakia. Down in the corner to Waldman. Three ball on the way. Good for Ashton. 40-27, Zilla by 13. As Jorgensen will have it in backcourt. Jorgensen across the timeline gives it off to Ramos. Ramos now top of the key. Ramos gives it off for Nunez. Nunez down into the corner. Here's Urrutia. And that shot blocked from behind by Luke. Going to be picked up by Ashton on the baseline. Here comes Ashton over on the left side. Gives it off for Delp. Three ball on the way from Clay is off the iron. Going to be rebounded down there and given off. And it'll be brought up the floor here by Nunez. He'll give over to Urrutia. And now it's thrown out of bounds. Awarded back to Zilla. So substitution into the ball game. We're going to get Buck back in as Urrutia is going to have a rest. So Clay will have it up top. Clay comes off a pick, back up top to Luke. Three ball on the way, offline. Going to be rebounded and brought up the floor quickly over on the left side in a traveling call. As we're going to get another substitute into the ballgame. Urrutia will come back. Lugo will come out. So 40-27, and Delp will go over on the right side now to Waldman. Waldman up top, and now swing it around to Delp. Delp tried to go down, and Luke tried to save it, but just a miscommunication between the two, and a turnover. 5:59 to play in the third. As they get the ball in for Buck, and now up the floor, Urrutia. And Urrutia gives off for Ramos. Ramos almost lost it, was able to chase it down. And now Jorgensen had it blocked from behind by Luke, and now it's dribbled on the baseline. They'll say it's out of bounds, awarded back to Wahluke. So 5:43 to play. Nakia got a hand on that one, knocked it back out of bounds. So Urrutia again to inbound. Gets it in for Buck. Buck out for Ramos. And now Nunez will have it up top. He'll hand it off. Here's Buck from about 21 feet. That's no good. And our long rebound is grabbed by Nunez. So Nunez gets it over. Here's Jorgensen for a long one. And that's an air ball. Going to be grabbed by Nakia. So here comes Ashton with the basketball. Long pass to Perez. Gives back to Delp. Delp right side. Out to Ashton in the right wing. Looked at the shot, didn't take it. Now one dribble back up top to Perez. Over to Luke. Three ball. That's offline. Going to be rebounded here by Urrutia. And he'll control it. Give it off to Buck. Buck right side. Back to Urrutia. Urrutia comes down on the right side. Now he'll retreat beyond the arc and gives it off to a cutter down the lane. We're going to get a whistle and a foul. That's going to be on Ashton. And Nunez will go to the line here. 4:57 to play in the third. 40-27 Zilla. The first free throw is hit by Nunez. We're going to get Sandoval and Torres back in. Perez and Nakia John will check out. Second one missed. Luke goes up to get the rebound. So here comes Delp. Delp now up the floor. Gets it up top for Luke. Luke just drives down the right side of the lane. Gets one off the window and through. 42-28. As Jorgensen will bring it up. Jorgensen had it knocked out of his hands. Is able to chase it down over there on the left side. One dribble back out to Ramos. Ramos now down into the corner. Gives it up. Here's Urrutia for a three, and he hits. 42-31. So Sandoval will bring it up the floor. Gets it over on the left side for Delp. Now up top, Waldman, he fell down with it. Ramos was there to pick it up. Ramos, bounce pass over to Urrutia, and he gets the free throw, the lay-in, and it is a 9-point game, 42-33. As Delp now will drive down, puts one off the window and in, and it is Zilla by 11, 44-33. As Ramos will bring it up the floor. Ramos, a little up and under move, doesn't hit anything. Luke with the rebound, quickly up to Delp. And Clay will try a three from the right wing. That's off the back iron. Going to be rebounded down there. And bringing it down the floor, they'll put it up. Delp there for the rebound. So here comes Clay with a basketball. Clay on the right side now comes all the way down into the paint. We're going to get a whistle and a foul as Delp ended up on the floor here. And the foul is on River Buck, his first. We're going to get Garza into the ball game. Aiden Garza will check in. As Luke hits from the free throw line, makes it 46-33. Here's Buck. Buck will bring it into front court. Buck way out high on that right side will go over to Urrutia. And Urrutia now hands off for Buck. Buck changes directions, comes around up top, comes down into the lane, runs over the defender, and they called a block. Wow. Yvonne was there, set pretty well, and that looked to be an easy and the official was starting to indicate a charge, and I don't know what changed his mind, but something at the last second changed it to a block. So Nunez at the free throw line gets the first to go. One of those 50-50 calls you just flip a coin for, I guess. You couldn't argue either way as they'll get it over to Garza, and Garza loses it on the baseline, and it's a turnover. So 46-34, 2:55 to play here in the third. Bring it up the floor. And up top, Buck gives off to Ramos. Ramos will come down on the right side, had it knocked away. He has to chase it down. And now out to Nunez near midcourt. Nunez will come down right side and picks up the dribble. Caught there. Jorgensen bails him out. Jorgensen now elevated and went to throw it away. And that's going to go out of bounds, and it'll be awarded to Zilla. So here comes Delp. Rifles a pass down to Navarre. Inside to Torres. Torres got the bucket to go. No whistle. As it's 48-34. And now up top, Buck with the basketball. As Buck way out high now. Gives it off to Ramos. Ramos now bounce pass in. And Nunez in the paint. Kicks out to Jorgensen. Jorgensen bounce pass for Ramos. He runs over Yvonne, and then he's going to get called for the block again. Wow. Different official, but another one that was really close. And Yvonne Torres is going to pick up his third personal, two of them on what easily could have been called charges. As the first free throw is good from Ramos. Missed the second. Navarre there for the rebound, but then it's taken away by Urrutia, but he stepped on the end line. So here's Delp. Delp brings it up the floor here, a minute 55 to play in the third, as it'll get over on the right side. Now back to Delp. Delp, a little runner in the lane. Count it. He'll go to the line. 50-35. And a minute 47 to play. Clay will have one as Urrutia picks up foul number two. Missed the free throw. Rebounded by Nunez. And Urrutia up the floor. Gets it over on the left side to Buck. Kicked out to Urrutia. Urrutia now top of the key. Gives it to Jorgensen. Now here comes Nunez. Nunez into the paint. Changes directions with his feet. They're going to call a foul here. Aiden Garza did a pretty good job defensively. I think we had a little bit of a travel that the referee ignored when he did that jump stop. First one is good. Fifty to 36. A minute 28 to play in the third. And the second one is good. Or no good. Rebounded by Delp. Now a long pass for Garza. He'll lay it in. 52-36. A minute 19 to play. Bringing up the floor on the left side, Nunez. Nunez gives off to Ramos. Ramos out in that left wing. Now we'll give it off, and Nunez will have it. Nunez, free throw line, short. Ball batted, and it's going to be rebounded in there and given off to Buck. Final minute of the third. As they get it over on the left side to Ramos. And tried to go to Urrutia. That's going to go into backcourt. And now what do we got? A kick, and they're going to award it back to Wahluke. So they reset the shot clock. And they got some moisture on the floor. They want to get cleaned up after that exchange. Actually, I don't know that it was moisture. It was something on the floor. So 52-36. As they get the ball in and be walked up the floor by Buck. Got about a 13-second differential, shot clock to game clock. As they get it down on the right side for Ramos. Ramos now into the paint for Nunez. He puts it up and in. 52-38, 25 seconds to play, shot clock off. As Navarre will have it right side, finds a drive, gets the reverse to go. 54-38. And the Warriors will have the basketball and bring it into front court as they go over on the right side. Here's Buck for a three. That's off the iron. Rebound grabbed by Garza. Hooks a pass out to Delp. Delp from midcourt. Can't get it to go. They end a three. It is Zilla 54, Wahluke 38. We'll take a quick break. Come back with the fourth quarter after this timeout.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent.
Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice-cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Welcome back here, 54-38, as the Leopards lead by 16 as we start the fourth quarter. They'll have possession as they get it over to Avila, left side. Owen now will kick it back out to Waldman. Waldman gets down in the paint, and traveling is called as he mishandled up there. So 7:45 to play here. Urrutia will bring it up the floor. Urrutia into front court, gives it off to Nunez. Now over on the left side, Ramos. Ramos now will give it to Urrutia. Three ball on the way is no good, but we're going to get a foul call. And Owen Avila is going to pick it up. Urrutia will get three. First free throw is good. Second one is good. Urrutia will try for the hat trick and got it. 54-41 as Waldman will bring it up the floor. Gets it to Perez right side. Now up top for Avila. Swing it around, and here's Favilla for a three. That's short. Going to be rebounded and brought up the floor here by Nunez. Nunez makes a move down into the paint. Gets stuck in there and is able to put it in. So 54-43. As Waldman will bring it up the floor. Waldman comes down, a little runner, no good. And a rebound grab. Well, Nakia had it, but it was taken away. And now up the floor, we're going to get a whistle and a foul on Avila. And Avila upset that, saying he got ball. And that'll be number two on Owen. Nunez can make this a 9-point ball game if he hits both. Hit the first. 54-44. We're going to get Clay Delt back into the ball game, and also Luke Navarre. So Zilla with their starting five out there. Missed the free throw, but a putback by Urrutia makes this an 8-point game. 54-46. As Delp will have it up top. Gets it over to Perez. Now down on the baseline. They'll swing it around to Waldman. Up top, Delp. Three ball on the way. Back off the iron. Delp has the rebound. Delp now drives down the lane and went up and had a shot block. And now here comes Nunez with the basketball. Nunez comes down left side, and boy, taken away by Navarre. And we're going to get a whistle at midcourt. And this is going to go against the Warriors. So charged with the foul is Nunez. His first. It is only the fourth team foul. As a bounce pass to Waldman and an easy layup. A nice play between Delp and Waldman. 56-46. And now Urrutia for three. That's no good. Rebounded by Delp. Here comes Clay down the center of the floor. Goes over on the right side to Navarre. Navarre goes to the glass. Count it. He'll go to the line. Fouls on Jorgensen. That'll be his second. Luke will get one. Free throw short. Rebounded by Urrutia. And now Urrutia will bring it up and across the timeline. Over to Buck, right side. Now up top for Ramos. And Ramos, a little short jumper, is missed. Arutia there for the rebound, but has to save it over to Ramos. And now kicked out to Jorgensen. Here's Buck at the top of the key. Little runner from the free throw line won't go. It's going to be rebounded by John, given to Delp. Here comes Clay. Clay down into the paint, kicks it out, and now we're going to get an offensive foul called on Delp. Clay was driving into a lot of contact, didn't get the whistle, and I think a little bit of frustration as he went to fire that ball out into the wing. As Nunez will have it, gets it off to Arutia. Now up top, Jorgensen, and now we're going to get a bad pick on Buck. So swing it the other way. Sixth team foul. Zilla sitting on seven, so both teams in the bonus. As Waldman goes down on the baseline to Delp. Delp, a little up and under move, got that to go. 60 to 46, Zilla by 14, 5:06 to play here in the ball game. As Nunez will bring it down into the paint, stolen by Delp. Here comes Clay with it. Clay at the other end, and they're going to call a foul and send Clay to the line for the bonus. As they call it, clear up at the top of the key. No shot attempt. As now we're going to get a timeout taken by Wahluke. So we'll take a break and be back after this timeout.
Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Leopards basketball is brought to you by Waldman Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Waldman Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley.
Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof.
Nature's Restaurant is a proud sponsor of Leopard Sports, with two locations serving you breakfast, lunch, and dinner. 1705 West Lincoln in Yakima and 1902 South 3rd Avenue in Union Gap. It's Major's Restaurant.
Welcome back here. 60-46, Zilla by 14. 4:59 to play here in the ballgame. Delp at the line to shoot the bonus. Clay hits the front end, makes this a 15-point game. And he will get one more. 2nd one is short, rebounded by Jorgensen. So Jorgensen now will bring it up the floor and give off to Arutia. And now on a cut to the glass, Nunez scores it. 61-48. As Delp will bring it up right side. Delp now gets it over. Here's Luke for a three. That's no good. Long rebound, and Navarre's there to pick it up. And now we're going to get an offensive foul as Luke lowered the shoulder into Nunez. And no complaint from Luke. He knew he was guilty. Number 2 on Luke. 4:33 to play. So get it into Ramos. Ramos now will bring it into front court on the left side. Gives it to Jorgensen on the baseline. A little runner is no good. Rebound grabbed by John. Up the floor to Perez. Perez top of the key. Whoa. Went to give it off. I don't know what he was doing. That turnover. As they'll get it over on the left side and driving down is Nunez. Shot put up is missed. Rebound grabbed by Luke. He'll give it off to Delp. So Clay will bring it up the right side. Clay now makes a move. Gives off to Nakia, who scores it. 63-48. They're letting them play today, boy. I'll tell you, there's it. Every time somebody gets down into the paint, it's physical. As Arutia finds an easy bucket. 63-50. As Delp now on the left side had that ball knocked away. Going to be grabbed by Jorgensen and brought up the floor by Ramos. Ramos comes down off the right block and puts it off the window. 63-52. 3:25 to play here in the ballgame. As Delp steps into front court. Gets it over on the right side now to Navarre. Kicked out to Perez. Up top for Delp. Delp, left side. Shot put up. Good. 65-52. As they get a long pass up the floor. And now kicked out quickly into Ramos. He finds his easy opportunity. 65-54. As Luke will bring it up the floor. Luke tries the reverse, gets it to go. 67-54, and a timeout taken by Zilla. We'll take a break. We'll be back after this timeout.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
Sunnyside Tire Factory is now Green's Tire and Auto Service. Tire Factory has joined the Point S Group. Alignments, brakes, shocks, struts, coolant flushes, transmission flushes, power steering flushes, differential services, timing belts, tune-ups, all suspension work, batteries, custom wheels, on-the-farm service, and, of course, tires. 1410 Yakima Valley Highway in Sunnyside.
Welcome back here, 67-54. Leopards by 13. It'll be Wahluke basketball. As Arutia will bring it into front court. Gives it off to Ramos. Top of the key, he'll give it off to Buck. Now over on the left side with it is Nunez. Nunez now top of the key. Goes over to Arutia. Arutia comes up, kicks it out to Jorgensen. About a 23-footer from Jorgensen goes in. 67-57. So Waldman now will bring it into front court. As they'll get it up top for Sandoval. Now Navarre will have it. Down into the corner to Waldman. Out for Izzy. As they'll give it off now to Luke. Navarre makes a move into the paint. And, oh, had the perfect move, but just couldn't get it to go. Navarre ends up with a loose ball. And now out to Delp. As we're inside 2 minutes, Zilla will look to run some clock. As they'll get it over to Sandoval. Sandoval makes a move. Now goes down into the corner. Here's Waldman for a three ball, and he got another one. 70-57 with a minute 35 to play and a timeout taken by the Warriors. We'll take a break.
The Smudge Pot Clothing Company. Check out their Beanie in a Bin. A beanie packaged in a made-to-scale miniature apple bin. Shop online today at smudgepot.com. That's the Smudge Pot Clothing Company at smudgepot.com.
The Squeeze Inn is located in downtown Zilla, proudly celebrating 90 years as a local family-owned business serving our community. Open Thursday through Saturday from 4 to 8. Come in and enjoy our delicious prime rib at the famous Squeeze Inn.
Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent. Whether it's auto, home, life, business, maybe even renter's insurance, stop by and see Randy at 3800 Fruitvale Boulevard in Yakima or give him a call at 966-3636. Randy Wasilius, your farmer's agent.
Well, a minute 35 to play here in this one. It's 70-57 Zilla. And had some... Well, Luke is not really... given up at this point. They're fully capable of coming back here in a 13-point game. They've shown that they can hit the long ball, as now Buck will have it. Up top, Jorgensen. Back out to Buck. He'll try the three, and that's off the front. Going to be rebounded by Sandoval, and Zilla can run some clock here as they're going to try to foul early. Yep, and I don't think Nunez actually was trying to foul. I think he was trying to knock the ball away, but you know, that would be my strategy at this point. I think a lot of times coaches wait too long to start the foul game if you're behind, you know. Make this team hit some free throws with a minute and a half left. I mean, it may make you have a bigger loss as, well, there's a good example as they miss that one, and they are going to award this back to Zilla. And so now I think it's going to be awarded to Zilla. Nope, they change it. It's Wahluke ball. So a minute 16 to play. As it'll be brought up the floor here. And now at the top of the key, Nunez. Nunez will make a move down into the paint. Had it, lost the ball, got it back, was able to put it up and in. So 70 to 59. And now Delp over on the right side to Navarre. Navarre, and now he's fouled in backcourt. And Nunez is going to be called for this one as well. It'll be his third. So Navarre will go to the free throw line. And the funny thing is that Nunez is acting like he wasn't trying to foul and was upset that the foul was called as Luke hits the first. Probably the best thing that could have happened. You stop the clock. It gives you an opportunity. As although Navarre hits both ends. And now up the floor they'll come. And it's Nunez to the glass. That's no good. Delp grabs a rebound. Delp on the baseline. Oh, that was thrown away and picked up down on the baseline by Urrutia, who puts it in. So 72-61. And now they'll get it into Navarre. Luke will bring it up the right side. Luke all the way down baseline and tried to kick it out. That ball was batted, and now it'll be batted out of bounds, awarded. And they'll say it was off Waldman and out of bounds. So now a long pass up the floor quickly to Jorgensen, and a lay-in is good. 72-63, 25 seconds to play. As they'll get it over to Delp. Shot clock off. Delp now into front court. Goes over to Navarre, now down to Waldman in the corner. Waldman, a pump fake, now brings it out into the right wing, and they'll come grab him, and the foul will be called. 10.4 seconds, a little too late now with a 9-point deficit. So Ashton's free throw is good. It makes it a 10-point game, 73-63. So it's a four-possession game with 10.4 seconds left. Just not enough time as Ashton hits both. And now quickly up the floor, they'll kick out. And a three ball on the way, no good, rebounded. And Ashton just covering it up. And that'll be it. Final score is Zilla 74, Wahluke 63. And so that it will be your final. We will take a quick break. We'll try to come back and talk to somebody. I'm not too sure who. Probably maybe Ashton Waldman tonight. See who shows up. Be back after this timeout.
Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish. Come in for a great breakfast menu, or if you're in a hurry, pull up to our drive-thru for a quick espresso. We have daily lunch specials as well as a burger selection that is sure to satisfy everyone in the family. Does an ice cold root beer in a frosty mug sound good? Maybe top it off with some ice cream for a tasty float. Come by Dad's Family Restaurant 7 days a week for great food and super treats. Dad's Family Restaurant in Toppenish.
Leopard Basketball is brought to you by Waldman Produce, providing local schools, casinos, businesses, and institutions with the freshest produce around. It is Waldman Produce, serving you quality throughout the Yakima Valley.
Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber in Toppenish, stop by for great deals or check out our weekly flyer. Our friendly staff is happy to help you find what you need. Local retailers can't compete with the big box stores, and Ideal Ace Hardware and Lumber is proof.
Your local State Farm agent is Julian Calzada. He is located in downtown Zilla at 616 Railroad Avenue in Suite A. Stop by and visit, or you can call Julian at 509-314-6650. Julian Calzada, your local State Farm agent.
Patterson Masonry, professional masons specializing in custom brick, block, and stonework. Looking to add a beautiful rock fireplace or chimney? How about a stone pizza oven on your party patio? Give Patterson Masonry a call at 509-961-7925 and schedule your stonework today.
Welcome back here to Zilla Alumni Gymnasium. Leopards headed to the district championship next Saturday in Wahluke as Ashton. I'll tell you, you know, over the last few games, you know, Luke struggled to find the net, and Clay's been hurt, and you've been the constant. You've been the guy to step up.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm just that third man, I believe, like, if they have to come, if they go injured, you know, I'm the one that has to step it up. I'm a senior. I need to lead the team. I just feel like, you know, I have to do my thing.
Well, you've played well for the last several games, put up some points, and man, sometimes when you're stroking it, you're stroking it. I'll tell you. So, you guys are in the district championship. You can play either Toppenish or Royal. Who would you prefer to play?
Toppenish.
You want to play Toppenish?
Yeah, we want revenge.
Okay. So well, are any chance you're going to make it up there and watch that game at 7:30 tonight?
Probably not.
No?
I would just probably watch it on YouTube.
Well, tell me about this ball game tonight and these guys. These guys are pretty quick. They shot the ball well. What was the game plan going in?
Just to put them away early. We couldn't, like, you know, get something going. They were hanging with us, but that's not our motive, you know. Usually we got to put them away early, but that didn't happen tonight.
So it made for a tough ball game and came right down the stretch. And tell me about Urethia and having to guard that kid.
Which one?
Number 11.
I don't know. I was also hurt in the first quarter. I rolled my ankle pretty bad again. But I tried to play through it. But, yeah, he's tough. I mean, he is tough.
He is. He's a good ball player.
Yep, he's quick.
Yep, he is, and he can shoot it. So, all right, well, Ashton, we'll let you go take a shower. It looks like you worked up a sweat tonight, and I hope that ankle gets better. You got a week to heal it.
Yep.
Yeah, keep it on ice and keep writing the ABCs.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so we will talk to everyone again. Scotty, we miss you. We don't have any stats from Shannon. We miss you guys. Hope you guys are having fun down there. For Scotty Burge's senior night, we know that's where you're at. So, we miss you. And Ashton, we're glad you could join us. And
thank
I hope
you.
That everyone has a great, safe weekend. Mm-hmm. And we'll see you Monday.
Yep, thank
All
you.
Right. All right, so final score again is Leopards 74 and the Warriors 63. Leopards will take off and go a week and head into the district championship. The boys and the girls will both play on Saturday night. At Wahluke next Saturday night. So good night, everybody, and have a safe weekend. Good night, Grandma.